Welcome back to the channel. This is Weihao at Direct Impact Solutions. This week, we're doing an experiment with the new Execute FileMaker Data API script step introduced in FileMaker 19. Many of you must have heard about FileMaker's Data API that was introduced back in FileMaker 16. It is a RESTful API that allows external services and applications to interact with FileMaker. But what is this Execute FileMaker Data API script step, and how is it related or different from the actual Data API? The Execute FileMaker Data API script step is something that uses the same underlying functionality as the Data API itself. However, it doesn't actually call the FileMaker Data API on the FileMaker server. Using it won't consume any of your Data API quota, nor does it require the file to be hosted on FileMaker server. The script step will query data in the current file and receive the data in JSON format. It allows you to use the same query structure as if you are querying the actual Data API, again, without actually calling it. And it is supported on all FileMaker platforms, including FileMaker Pro, FileMaker Go, FileMaker Web Direct, FileMaker Server, FileMaker Cloud, Custom Web Publishing. It can even be called from the actual Data API itself. But enough about the introduction. The reason I made this video is that one of my coworkers asked me whether using the Execute FileMaker Data API script step to retrieve data has a performance gain over traditional methods. All right. So let's do an experiment. First, let me introduce the experiment setup. To put it simple, I have 10,000 records with unstored calculations that I need to aggregate using a summary field. As my control group, I used this script to just read the summary field value directly into a variable, and I measured the time it takes to do that. So it takes about 2 minutes and 20 seconds to finish that, and then set up one experimental group for client-side performance using the Execute FileMaker Data API script step. So it sets up a request in JSON, and then it used that to get back the summary field value. In addition to those two, I also want to measure server-side performance. So I use PSOS to call these two scripts so that they can run on the server side. And I have a third scenario here where I use insert from URL to actually call the FileMaker Data API and see how it performs. So let me ask you, how do you think this is going to play out in terms of performance? If you need some time to think, pause the video. Are you ready for the result? Okay, so it turned out that there's no obvious performance difference between getting the data directly from the layout versus using Execute FileMaker Data API script step to get it. So this one actually takes about the same time. It fluctuates every time I test it, but it's still around 2 minutes and 20 seconds. However, there is a big difference between running this on the server versus running this on the client. So these two options, which use the exact same scripts as these two options, except they were run from the server side. So these two have a significant performance gain compared to these two. Both of them only took 12 seconds to finish. If you compare 2 minutes and 20 seconds to 12 seconds, the performance gain is actually more than 10 times. So before we review the result of our last option, let's think about why there is a significant performance gain when running from the server. So this is because the main factor that slows down the performance here is the amount of remote calls. So in this particular setup, because I'm asking the system to do aggregation with unstored calculation over 10,000 records, when you run this from the client side, every time you're trying to retrieve that unstored calc's value, the client has to talk to the server to retrieve the value, and it just creates a huge amount of traffic between the server and the client. However, when running from the server side, I just make one call to the server with my request, and then most of the calculations are done on the server side, and the server will simply pass the result back to me. So there's not a whole lot of traffic between the server and the client, which is why the performance improved a lot. If you want to learn more about improving WAN performance, check out this video we made linked down below. So back to the last option, using insert from URL to call the actual data API. Now that you understand what's determined the performance here, you should be able to tell whether this method is going to be fast or slow. With this method, we make one HTTP call to the server. The server handles all the calculation on the server side and then pass the result to us. Sounds familiar? Indeed, it is very similar to these two methods. And the test result actually verifies that. It took exactly 12 seconds for this method to get the data. So one more thing to note here is that as long as you're running this from the same machine, there's no significant performance difference between these two or between these three. So this probably means that all these methods use the same underlying core functionality to calculate the summary field value. And essentially, there are different wrappers around the same core functionality. So does this experiment result aligns with your answers? Leave us a comment to tell us whether you got it right. If you like this video, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. We publish FileMaker videos every week. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.